What's going on, world? I'm Kevin Hart, and I want to welcome you to Coldest Balls Season 10, live from Vegas. Just two defensive players about to talk and chop it up. Two big guys. Come on, man.
I'm not used to this.
What up, world? I'm excited because on this live episode, we got a live personality, somebody I can call a friend. Somebody that called a phenomenal player. The only thing that's stupid is that he plays for the Dallas Cowboys, which is unfortunate. Please welcome Micah Parsons to the show, everybody. I want to get right to it. Coming out of college, did you expect your success to come as fast as it did?
I wouldn't say I expected. I think I worked for it, and I understood that it would take mountains to get to where I am at now. A lot of guys took me in, and I'm extremely grateful for that.
What vets?
Guys like Leo Collins, Tyron Smith, they saw my potential, and they kind of like grabbed me and was like, hey, you should try this. You should look at this person. You should add this to your game, and it will make you such a better player. I just want to learn so much so I can be like almost unstoppable.
Would you say that the studying aspect to the game has kind of overpowered the physical approach?
I would say, and this is just for me personally, and I'm grateful that I had this guy as my coach, because coaching truly matters. If people say it's all players, it's complete lies.
Okay.
Coaching truly matters, and that's George Edwards. I would say my film game, when I came into the league, was probably on like a 3 compared to what he taught to me. Like
a 3 out of what? Out of 10?
Out of 100.
Really?
Because there's so much more disguise. There's so much more things that they hide. But it's really just a fake facade of what they really don't want you to see. Like all the shifts, all the motions, all the counters. Do you learn the down and distance? What are they going to do on third down? What are they doing on second down? When they're in shotgun, are they a pass team? Like if you play a team like Detroit, if they're under center, they're running the ball 85% of the time.
Okay.
But when they're a gun, it's almost 100% pass or screen.
By the way, I knew that. I've watched that tape. I've studied the Lions probably just as much as you have. I think we share a lot of similarities in just understanding how to break the game down.
Yeah.
You know I played.
What'd you play?
My church league. It's a big thing. Everybody here knows about my background in the church league.
The kids league?
It was a church league. It was pastors.
In the kids league?
No, not the kids,
kids
league.
Kids, five-year-olds.
What is your problem? I want to talk about leadership. Right? What has your role been as a leader in that locker room? And are you respected as such? Good question, Kevin.
You know, I would say I took more of a laid-back approach for a while, just because like, when I first walked in that locker room and I saw Tyron Smith and he had a six-pack and he's 315 pounds, I was like, yo, what the?
Insane.
People forget, as players, we're still fans, too. So I'm like a big fan of these guys.
It's crazy that you say that, because when you saw me here today, I saw that you were a fan. You like, Kevin, this is crazy. I can't even believe I'm doing this. And I was like, calm down. I'm just a regular guy, right? I'm just a host. And he was like, but you do so much. You're such a big movie star.
Okay. Delusion is a hell of a place.
Hey, man. I don't understand why they laughed at
that. I can see why you. I did text you and said that was a good movie. If y'all ain't watch it, y'all should go watch it.
Get in the tub, man. Get in the tub. We're going down deeper tub. The question's about to get harder. Let's go. Come on, man. Come on. That's right. It's cold, because it's a cold tub.
I'm used to this.
That's right. Well, you should be. It's
get
what
deep.
All athletes
you gotta
like
get deep.
Do. It takes me a second. I go three tiers.
That says a lot about you.
I don't care. You don't hurt my feelings. You don't hurt my feelings at all. I want to ask you another question, man. You know, you're actively doing journalism at the same time, right? You are actively speaking about football. Why did you make the decision to start doing that this early in your career? Daryl. Yeah. All right, that's enough. Good job, Daryl. Hit him with it. By the way, he hates the Cowboys. Bam, what the
f
is your
addition.
Problem?
Get him another bucket.
Bam, you throw it down there, you son of a bitch. Bam. Yeah, that's right. Yeah. Yeah. And we don't have insurance, so that's on you.
Sue him.
Yeah, well. All right, let's get back to you. Give me a second, because that was really cold.
You're soft
really
like that?
Look, we're not here to talk about the bad. We're here to talk about the good. And speaking of good, white hand. There it is. Thank you, white hand. Well, the secret to my success is simple. It's Old Spice Total Body Deodorant Stick. Gives you 24/7 freshness from your pits all the way down to your toes and down below with daily use. It's the secret to my success and always has been. White hand, thank you. Micah, you need to get you some. I smelt you when you came out here. Smelt like cowboy ass. Okay, why did you make the decision to start doing that this early in your career?
You know, for me, it's always about not where you're at right now, but where you're going to be. I think you should always be trying to be better for yourself later down the road? Because, you know, this game don't last forever. I can't say that I'm going to be dominant for a decade. You want
to
be.
I think that it's very smart. Also think it's good for you to be thinking outside the game of football while playing football. That's the message that a lot of these younger players sometimes don't get. That's what's overlooked. You know, I thought that my career was going to last forever, and it didn't. You know, I took a hit from Pastor Troy, so I had to miss some games. I missed a perfect season.
You missed a couple Sundays?
We was on our way to a perfect season, right? And it's never been done in the church football leagues. I know
it hasn't,
like,
apparently.
That's something I'm dealing with. Okay, I got more questions for you. How do you feel about the way your season ended this year? Was it an emotional moment for you? If we could push in on his face right now, like, his energy just dropped. Your face twisted a little bit, like, it was like, dun, dun, dun. It was really sad. So I want to get into that. Let's get into the emotions of it.
Yeah, I can't lie. Like, when you put a lot into the game and you put a lot into, like, what you want to be and how you want to be, obviously when the outcome doesn't reach of what your expectations is, it's frustrating.
And tell me about it.
And it's demoralizing, and not how I wanted my season to end. I did think it was our year, and for some reason, we just didn't put it together. And, but it's hard to get on top of the hill.
I mean, as a guy who's gotten over the top of the hill, and it's
but
still
how long
on the
did
hill.
It take you?
Well, I mean, if you really want to know.
Because, Kev, I was a fan. I seen your stand-ups, what you was doing. It took you a minute.
20 years. That's all it took.
And that's where the Cowboys is at right now. Just to know, we're about to get over that hill.
You think the Cowboys are at 20 years?
We're a little over 20.
Troy Aikman and Emmitt Smith are both 78 and 83 years old now. So the last time that you guys done anything, yeah, that's a long time ago, man. That's a long time ago, which is fine. Okay, you're in the locker room. It's game time. What's the preparation that you go through?
Yeah, so, like, the whole week, like, or just the game focus.
Game day. You heard what I asked.
I mean, I feel like the preparation starts on Monday.
This is why you're an asshole. This is because of this, okay? I'm talking about, do you eat an orange? Do you take a scoop of peanut butter?
You ain't say that. You ain't say what's my pre-day meal.
What's your pre-game regimen?
Yeah, I mean, instead of Red Bull, I drink Noco.
That's it?
No, I mean, let's say the game, because we get primetime. Let's just say we are a 4 o'clock game.
Why do they keep giving the Cowboys primetime games?
Because we're the best.
I know, but at some point, I feel like these networks got to get smart and go, get these assholes off of TV. What are they doing?
Who would you prefer?
Well, the Eagles are just a much better program.
So you could just push your quarterback in the end zone?
You son of a... You son of a...
Nobody wants to watch it. What? I'm sorry.
Who the fuck is clapping? Hey! Bam! Daryl! I want them removed.
Listen, sorry.
And your jealousy for the Philadelphia Eagles is insane. And
I'm
me
not
and you
jealous.
Talked about this.
I'm just saying, you saying why we not on TV when we the star. We the show.
Another question, man, before we go. What other things are you looking to involve yourself in at the young space and place in your career?
That's a good question.
You got right of this because I'm a good host.
For me, I'm really just trying to get into things that make me happy.
Okay.
I'm not going to lie, I played pickleball one time, fell in love with pickleball, and next thing you know, I start ownership in a pickleball team.
There you go.
You should drive whatever makes you happy, and I just think that, you know, that's just big for me.
Well, I'm going to tell you what makes me happy, man, seeing your success. I know you as a person, and all jokes aside, I can give you cowboy shit all day. You're a dope individual. I think you should just keep going, man. Sky's the limit for you, and it's much more. What are you doing? Bam, we're wrapping it up. We're wrapping it up. We don't need no more ice, and you need to be careful. That's how you fell and bust your ass. Go sit down. Sit down, bitch. Son of a... Get off, Daryl. Go some... This is why y'all shouldn't even be here for these live episodes. You shouldn't be here. Micah, I gotta be honest, man. I'm happy. I'm happy that you understand what happiness means. Keep chasing your happiness, all right? And the only way that you're gonna get there is to get the out of Dallas. You gotta find another program.
Who?
You gotta find another program.
Who said it?
The Eagles. You figure out a way to get to Philadelphia and happiness will find you faster.
Where's the Eagles at?
Philadelphia. What do you mean, where are we at?
Where are you at right now?
The same place you are, sitting on the same couch.
And your methodology, I should be in Kansas City.
You want to play for Kansas City. That was breaking news here on Coldest Balls. we just got breaking news here on Coldest Balls. Micah Parsons one time, ladies and gentlemen. Show some love. Huh? Coldest Balls, get your ass out the tub. And be careful walking out here, man. Get up.
My shorts is tight, bro.
Your shorts are tight? Oh, cute. Guys, if we could go to freeze frame cutout, Micah's got a situation he don't want the world to see.